Today we are in District 15 to view a corner terrace of about 2,600 square foot unit in Opera Estate. Hi, I'm Warren Chan, Principal Real Estate Consultant of Propseller. If you're looking for a very convenient but yet quiet area, freehold landed, this is a property you should not miss. Shall we go and take a look? Let's go. Located in the rest of Central Region, Terang Bulan Avenue is within the Opera Estate in District 15, which comprises of East Coast and Marine Parade. If you look at landed terrace homes that have a freehold tenure, District 15 currently has a capital appreciation of 35.23%, which is an extremely competitive and appealing rate for any investors. Furthermore, the average PSF within District 15 is 2,044 per square foot, and yet our property is currently being marketed at 1,917 per square foot, which does indicate a pretty competitive entry into a freehold terrace within District 15. Our property is also a corner terrace, which has a larger land appeal, which is typically in demand among homeowners, which should mean a higher market value. We'll look further into the affordability of our unit in a short while, but in the meantime, let's go check out our property. Walking through the gate, this is where the car porch is, where you can easily fit in one car. So right next to the car porch, there's this very big area here that can be used for gardening, landscaping, or even a koi pond. The whole idea is to make this house more livable and with a touch of greenery. So with that, let's step into the house. Oh yeah, before we do, actually, before stepping into the house, I can see that the wall is here. This is, as a matter of fact, is an extension of the original boundary wall out here. So it gives the whole house more internal space to use. Come, let's go in and take a look. So the moment when you step into this area, right, this is a pretty versatile area that can be used as an entertainment, reading, or even like just a normal sitting area, just like a welcome area where when your visiting friends, relative comes, right, you can always hold them down here. So you can see that the space is very big and versatile. You can easily, even considering putting a pool table down here. So so the whole idea is to actually give this whole house, right, a lot more inner space where the homeowner and actually people staying in the house to use. Before stepping into the actual living area, allow me to also highlight, right, this big versatile area here also comes with two big panels of windows that brings in a lot of natural light for the unit. So now stepping into the living area, there's one nice small corner here that, well, of course you can always consider using as a reading area or even putting a very nice big massage chair over here for you to enjoy a massage at the end of a very hectic day. So with that, I also wanted to say at behind there's also a window that brings in all the natural light. So now it's not difficult to see that the living area itself is quite big and regular. So over here right now, the current setting is as such, right? But you can also consider putting an L-shaped sofa here with that as a backdrop, hanging your wall TV over there, and so that it leaves enough clearance for you to walk into the dining area. So now we're just going to go and see the dining area, okay? So the dining area is also pretty good size over here, easily sit up to 6 at this present moment. But you can always reorientate the dining table into this way, so it can sit up to even 10 or 12. So again, there's one nice big window panel here that brings in all the natural light. Or at points, if you do not want to use the aircon, you can always leave the windows open and allow the breeze to flow in. Now, this would be the perfect fixer-upper property where renovations can be done to really bring the space alive and to your liking. If you look at some of the new sales terrace units that are currently under construction by the developers, you would be looking at fairly expensive options. In the area, there are two of such new developments which are priced at 3,667 per square foot and $3,777 per square foot, with land sizes at 1,309 square feet and 1,398 square feet respectively. Putting that into context, our property has a size of 2,605 square foot and a PSF of 1,917. Hence, the affordability is clear, allows you to get more bang from your buck in terms of space. On top of that, if we look at the past transactions within Opera Estate, there were two similar size units that changed hand in March 2023. A 2,400 square foot and 2,596 square foot Freehold Terrace were transacted at 2,111 PSF and 2,562 per square foot respectively. Again, our property at 1,917 stands out quite clear as the winner in terms of affordability. In terms of rental prospect, our property does enjoy a big advantage because of its location. Opera Estate as a whole has an average rental of $4,435 per month, and zooming in, the average rental of properties between 2,000 to 3,000 square foot within Opera Estate is at $4,650 per month. However, what is interesting is that our unit had a previous tenancy commanding $5,700 per month and also receiving an offer at $7,000 per month, which was higher than the average rental in the area. This is likely due to the optimal locations of the subject property, which is closer to the main road, making it extremely convenient for those that travels primarily via public transportation. So stepping into the kitchen, let's move on in. So in order to keep this kitchen enclosed from the dining area, right, there's a sliding door here which you can use to close off the area. And coming on in, it's not hard to realize this is a very generous, spacious amount of space. To have 3 to 4 people working in the area will not be too cramped, and they will not easily bump into one another. And with that said, right, for those who would like to reconfigure your kitchen, you can also consider bringing down this wall so that the entrance and the flow will also be a lot more easier. So with that said, the current setup of the kitchen is you have actually a lot of countertop and also the carpentry space on both sides to give it an enormous amount of storage space. And over at the countertop is also very generous. It's like a very long countertop. You can easily put in all your household appliances like juicer, coffee making machine, and also toaster. And finally, over at this side is the preparation area. Again, very generous amount of space that makes it very easy just before you cook them over at this stove here. And also there's a hood over here. Last but not least, before I forget, there's also this window again to ventilate the area so that it will not be too stuffy during times where heavy cooking takes place. And there's also a floor trap that makes cleaning and maintaining of this area a lot easier because you can simply splash water and scrub the floor and you'll be able to clean up the whole area very easily. And over at the back here is the wash area. You have a very big double sink. So after dinners or meals, right, it's easy to actually do all the washing. Last but not least, in terms of flow of the house, right, there's also a gate here that you can actually open up to lead you into the yard area, so that really you do not have to go all the way to the front door to go out to the yard area. So this really makes the whole house and the flow movement a lot easier and accessible. So with that said, please follow me. Stepping into the yard area, it's not hard to realize, being a corner terrace, it gives you all this additional amount of space that you can use. So current owner has already tiled up the entire section of this space here. Of course, leaving a good section for gardening and also for landscaping. Another thing to note is the shelter that has been extended. So it kind of wrap around the perimeters of this house. And over at this area here, that can also be used like a barbecue area. With that said, there's also this backyard that's mainly used for balconies and washing, or maybe even an extension of a dry kitchen over at this side. With that said, there's also a roller blind that can be totally brought down to give this whole area the full privacy that it requires. Stepping up to level 2, this is the floor where you have all the 3 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, and also 1 shower area. Something to note about the bedroom is that it all comes very spacious, easily fitting in a king-size bed, wardrobe, and also a work desk. All the rooms also come with a few large panels of window, meaning whenever it's opened up, it brings in a lot of breeze and also natural daylight. One thing to note, this room on my left, being the largest among the other two, you can also consider putting in an ensuite also, still leaving you with good space to put in a king size and also a full-length wardrobe. In terms of transportation, we are located in between Bedok and Kembangan on the east-west line. Bedok MRT, being the closer of the two stations, is just an 11 minutes walk or 5 minutes drive away. Kembangan, on the other hand, is a 15 minutes walk and a similar 5 minutes drive away. As mentioned earlier, one of the key features of this property is the location it enjoys within the landed residential enclave. The property is located on the second lane from the main road, which is an excellent position where you're not by the main road with constant traffic, yet also not too deep in that you would be too far away from the nearest public transportation. From the property, it is also a short 5 minutes walk to the closest bus stop that will bring you to Bedok MRT in 2 stops. From Bedok MRT, it is a short 4 stops away to Paya Lebar, which also connects you to the Circle Line, and another 4 stops down to Bugis, which also brings you to the Downtown Line. For those who drive, the Central Business District is an 18-minute drive away via Major Expressway, PIE or Changi Road. You are also a short drive from ECP that would bring you to Marina Bay area, passing along the East Coast. For families with school-going children, there are multiple primary and secondary school options in the area, with Opera Estate Primary and King Yi Secondary within a 1 kilometer radius, while Bedok North Secondary, Telok Kurau Primary and Bedok Green Secondary all close by as well. Where access to amenities is concerned, Bedok Mall is a short 5 minutes drive away, and there you would find access to an array of grocery, retail, dining and lifestyle shops. Closer to home, you would find multiple cafes and restaurants a stone throw away, like Saffron's at Swan Lake, Baker's & Co, and Biz by Ashton and Popeye, just to name a few, with nearby supermarket like FairPrice at Chai Chee, Prime and iTech all close by. That'll be all for today. Thank you for staying tuned with me throughout this entire home tour. If you'd like to see more of such exclusive home video, do subscribe and click on the notification bell below. If you find this beautiful freehold corner terrace is suitable and you'd like to have a physical view, do reach out to my Propseller team today. With that, I'll see you the next round. Goodbye.